Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let me show you some creative ways that you could use the Maps app to create content to send in an email or use in apps like Pages, Keynote, or iMovie. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 500 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So let's say you want to make up a map with some annotations, maybe, and send it in an email. You may think the best way to do that is to find the location you want and then share by email. But it doesn't quite work very well. So for instance, here I can zoom in on Central Park and maybe I want to rotate the map and then draw on it. So first thing I would do is go to Share and then Mail. But right away there's a little bit of a problem in that the preview is a little too small, and you can see it doesn't even obey the rotation there. It's more of a link to a map location than anything else. So instead of doing that or using any share option here, I'm going to print. Now you can export as a PDF, but print gives you more options right here up front. I can click the Show Details button here at the bottom, and now one of the things I can do is do a horizontal view, which is probably more how I have the window and map set up in the first place. And then instead of exporting as a PDF, which would create a file and then I'd have to open that file, I can go and just say Open in Preview. I can also send in mail here and then get a more accurate representation of what's going on. But opening in Preview allows me to edit it and then share it in various ways. So let's do that. So here I am in Preview now, and you can see the map. It's not exactly the same as what I see in Maps here. It's a little bit cut off, but you can experiment a little bit by zooming in or out before you use Print to get this preview here. Now that I'm in Preview, I can use the markup tools here at the top, and I really can do anything I want with it. So for instance, I can do a circle here, and then let's change the border to a red. I can drag this into a complete circle by holding the Shift key. Makes it a circle rather than an oval. Position it where I want. I can draw lines. Lines with arrows. I can even freehand draw, which could be a quick and easy way to do things. So for instance, if I wanted to trace a route, I could do that pretty easily. Then I can add other shapes to it. I could add text here, and then as I add as much text as I want. I could of course include emoji in the text as well to create symbols. There's a ton of different mapping symbols. So for instance, I can go to text there, and then I could select it, do Command Control Space, and it brings up the character chooser, and I could search for just about anything I want. So I can do this little running person emoji here. Really, the sky's the limit for what you want to go and create here using the annotation tools. And then when you're done, you could simply save and save this out as a PDF that you can do various things with. But you could also directly share it here, say using mail, and you get this annotated map here in the message without ever having to actually save a file. Now let's zoom back out. You can zoom out for really big views, like say the entire United States, like this, and use that as a map for things. And you can use these maps in all sorts of different places. Matter of fact, it could be as easy as copy and paste. So say you wanted a map of the 48 continental United States, and you wanted to use it in Pages. So you can run Pages, create a new document, and if I go into Maps here, and all I do is copy, Command C or Edit Copy, then I'll switch over to Pages and Command V to paste. It's actually going to paste the exact map I'm looking at here as a graphic. So I can quickly get clip art for Pages. And if I'm writing about various different locations, I could be changing the map location all the time, quick copy and paste, and now I've got a map in here. If I double click on it, of course in Pages you can do all sorts of things like zooming in or adjusting the crop of a map for whatever you want, and add borders and all sorts of things, just like it was a regular image or photograph. You could do the same thing in Keynote. So I could do Command C here in Maps, switch to Keynote, and Command V, and we'll paste the map in my slide here in Keynote, and I could resize it and use it how I want, as part of a slide or the entire slide or anything. And remember, here in Maps you don't just have to use the standard map look. You can also go to Satellite View and get a satellite view of things, which could create some really interesting graphics that you can use in your presentations or documents. There's also 3D View, So you could go and zoom in usually on a city near the center, switch to 3D, and then if you go close enough to downtown, usually the buildings are then in 3D like they are here in the map of Denver. And then you can rotate the map and get the view that you want. Now for some reason this doesn't work with copy and paste. If I were to copy this, you'd think I'd get exactly what I see here, but if I paste it into Pages or Keynote, I get a flat 2D view of the same area. But I can go and print and then open in preview, and it creates 3D view there. I can then copy from preview, go over into Keynote and paste, and I'll get the 3D view there. Now this also seems to be true of satellite views or 3D satellite views like this one. Whenever you try to copy and paste and you don't get what you expect, then go to the print option and print to preview or print and save as PDF, and then you should get exactly what you see. So you can also use these maps in iMovie, but unfortunately you can't copy and paste like you can with Pages and Keynote. So you have to go and then print and then open in preview or save as PDF after changing some options. So maybe make the orientation horizontal here, for instance. Once you have a PDF, you could bring that into iMovie. So here I've created this PDF here, and let's go into iMovie and I drag and drop it in. And now I've got something I could use. I want to set the cropping either to, you know, fit or fill, maybe make it so that I don't get these edges of the PDF here like that. And then I've got a nice little map that I could add in as a graphic element. Of course, you could do the same thing using satellite views, whether zoomed all the way in or zoomed far out, to make really good content for your videos, especially if your video is about a specific location. There's so much you can do with this. Whether it's a document you're writing, a presentation you're giving, or a video you're making, there's usually a location associated with what you're talking about. So throwing in a map or a 3D satellite view can really enhance your work. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.